सेंस ऑफ माइक उसे, अरे नहीं होगा हमसे नहीं हो पाएगा, मतलब मैं उन्हें यही बोलता हूँ कि अगर नहीं हो पाएगा तो मत ही दो एग्जाम,
हाँ
एग्जाम हो पाएगा तभी देना है, इस तरह से होना चाहिए लोग मेरे हिसाब से।
राइट, हाय गाइस, माय नेम इज अनुज जिंदल एंड टुडे आई हैव विश्वनीत सिंह, आई होप आई एम प्रोनाउंसिंग इट करेक्टली। ही ओरिजिनली हेल्स फ्रॉम यूपी बट ही इज बीन ब्रॉट अप इन मिजोरम, सो अ वेरी गुड मिक्स ऑफ द नॉर्थ इंडिया एंड नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया, एंड ही इज एन इंजीनियर बाय हिज एजुकेशनल बैकग्राउंड। ही इज वर्कड इन कोल इंडिया लिमिटेड फॉर सम टाइम एंड नाउ फाइनली ही इज गॉट सेलेक्टेड इन SEBI as a grade A officer. So today we will pick up some very interesting questions which might be important for all the engineers out there who are aspiring to be, joining SEBI especially. And we will start very shortly with them. So Vishwanid, if you want to introduce yourself and start by saying something, we can do that. Otherwise, we can start with the questions directly.
Sir, I think you have given a decent introduction, so I don't need to
परफेक्ट परफेक्ट, ठीक है। तो सबसे पहला क्वेश्चन विच आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ इंजीनियर्स आर कंसर्न अबाउट इज हाउ डिफिकल्ट और हाउ इजी इज द प्रिपरेशन फॉर सेबी कंसिडरिंग दैट यू आर नॉट फ्रॉम द कॉमर्स बैकग्राउंड।
So initially, I think because the SEBI syllabus was drastically changed from the last time, so initially I had that thought in my mind that it, I might not be able to crack it, but because of the postponement of the exam, I could have a decent amount of time. So I started seriously preparing for it, and then because it's important that if we have an aim in our mind that we have to crack it, then anyhow, sir, it is possible, because SEBI in its notification itself has mentioned clearly that engineers are eligible. So that I give a lot of emphasis on that, because engineers are eligible. So I think I must be able to clear it if I study hard.
तो मुश्किल था बट आई थिंक यू वर एबल टू हैव अ पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड टुवर्ड्स इट दैट बिकॉज आई एम एलिजिबल देन आई शुड बी एबल टू क्रैक इट, सो यू वर एबल टू एटलीस्ट मेक अ वेरी डिसेंट अटेम्प्ट एट इट, राइट?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
परफेक्ट परफेक्ट। तो व्हाट हैपेंड लास्ट ईयर वाज द नोटिफिकेशन फर्स्ट केम इन मार्च एंड देन इट केप्ट गेटिंग डिलेड बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड, एंड आई रिमेम्बर दैट अ लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स वर वेरी फ्रस्ट्रेटेड, दे वर नॉट स्टडिंग एट ऑल। आई यूज टू गेट कॉल्स रेगुलरली कि भाई पढ़ना है नहीं पढ़ना है कैसे पढ़ना है। सो हाउ डिड यू डील विद दैट टाइम पीरियड वेयर देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ कंफ्यूजन एंड फ्रस्ट्रेशन एज टू व्हेन विल दे कंडक्ट द एग्जामिनेशन?
Sir, at that time, I think last year in around March or April, I was also very confused whether or not RBI will come up with notification, SEBI, what will SEBI do. So, whatever time I was getting, at that time, because my job profile was also a bit hectic, so whatever time I was getting, I was watching videos. I had purchased your course, so I was watching videos and trying to make notes. And I thought, I had that thought in my mind that whatever I do right now, it will be helpful for me in the long run. So, although it was not a very serious preparation, but I would say I was not wasting a lot of time on mine, even when there was uncertainty about getting the exam. So I think one should keep focusing, and because as long as one is studying, it will never be, it will always be handy in future also. So one should keep.
So how was it like, because you are an engineering student, let's say you're spending 2 hours, 3 hours, whatever, every day watching videos and covering the chapters and concepts. So how was it like learning commerce subjects? Was it interesting? Was it monotonous? Did you feel that you're learning, reading it for learning, or you're reading it just for clearing the examination?
Sir, I found it personally, I found it interesting, especially subjects like finance, economics, accounts. I found them really interesting because they are pretty much related to companies, and we generally we all work in some companies. So I think for me it was very interesting, and it depends upon one's own mentality also, because I have some friends of mine who are also engineers, and they think that they are studying just for clearing the exam. But if we look at the subjects with a positive attitude, then they'll become interesting to us and help us clear the exam also. So attitude really matters, I think. And
So
we should try and link everything with our current job. For example, while studying company sector also, I was trying to look at what whole India is like, my
right.
current organization, and I was trying to link it with the subject. And if we try to link it, then it becomes interesting, and we can clear the exam.
Yes, that makes sense. You have to link it with something real so
Yes.
that you're able to remember it better. So if you had not got selected, let's assume that you had not got selected. and you were to give the examination again this year, then would you still have the same mentality of learning for clearing the examination, or would you change it to reading for clearing the examination?
So I think if we try to learn, then it becomes more easier for us to remember things and to understand, which will help us clear the exam. So I think my attitude would remain the same, that it is more important that we learn from the syllabus.
Right, you're right, you're right. So, okay, we will move towards all the subjects one by one. But before that, ek do questions utha lete hain. So last year, in fact, this year, starting in January, we had a revision series that I thought might be handy for students. So I want to know, it's a feedback, number one, plus something that I want to do in this year's examination, also before the examination. So were the revision videos at any point fruitful for you in clearing the examination? Exam ke time pe lag raha tha ki yaar ye revision mein padha tha, wo aa gaya.
Yes, sir. So I think revision videos were really helpful, because when we study different topics separately, and there is a huge span of time that we spend on studying. So when everything gets consolidated in a single video or in two or three sessions, for example, then I think it is really easy for us to recapitulate everything. So I think it was very helpful.
So wo fir se continue karna chahiye. Right.
Yes, sir. I think they will definitely, those videos will definitely help each other.
ठीक है, ठीक है. So let's now get to the six subjects one by one, and then probably we'll talk about something else. So let's start with, let's say, finance, because I think that's one of the favorite subjects of yours. So how did you deal with finance? Which sources did you use, and how did you make sure that when you are going for the examination, you feel confident about it? कि यार अब इतना पढ़ लिया है, now I can attempt a good number of questions.
So my approach towards finance was, I had first of all started my preparation with finance, because I thought it would be more interesting and more related to work profile of SEBI. So I had started with finance, and I had watched the videos, and I had made notes also. But I would suggest making notes is a bit tedious, and we should refer to PDFs. If I were to study again, then I would do this. That is what I would suggest to future aspirants. And we can add on those PDFs, whatever we feel is important. And if we refer to some other sources, that also we can add on to those PDFs, or to some cloud source, something like that. So I had referred to videos, made notes, and then revised with the help of PDFs. So that was my strategy.
Okay. Was the strategy the same if we talk about economics, accounts, costing, or was there any different? Let's now talk about, let's say, Companies Act, because you were referring to Companies Act.
So Companies Act, because it is a different kind of subject altogether, we have to mug a lot of things. My strategy for Companies Act was that first of all, I had watched the videos, I had made notes, and for subjects like Companies Act, it is very important that we make notes, because we have to remember them and we have to revise them on a continuous basis. So on my first revision, what I had done was, I was trying to remember the concepts, not the facts, for example, penalties or the number of days, something like that. I was not trying to remember those things while I first revised the syllabus or the subject. And then in my second preparation, or in the second revision session, I had tried to remember the facts. So that is what I had focused on. That helps, because if we remember facts prior to our exam, then it is better.
Better. I think this is something that I get a lot of queries even now. A lot of students, when they're going through their first coverage, they focus too much on facts. And I keep telling them that focus on concepts, not facts at this point of time. The fact might change when you actually go to the exam. So I think that's something very beautiful that you've brought about. You were also referring to using the example of Coal India Limited while you were covering Companies Act. Can you elaborate on that a little bit?
So for example, we can go to the website of my current organization and then look at what is the authorized, or any other thing, like we can look at who are the members of the board of directors, or who is the independent director, and what is a company secretary. Before, we used to get some circulars from our current organization, but we could not relate it with what we do on a daily basis. But after going through Companies Act, I think it was a better feeling that I could understand things, and I was feeling that I'm getting to know these things, so it felt good, and I was able to more concentrate on the subject.
Perfect. Makes sense. Because if you can connect it with something real, as I had said before, then you can remember it better, right? Now, costing and accounts are something which probably need a lot of time for any engineer, for any person from non-commerce background, because there are so many basics involved in accountancy and costing. So how did you deal with that? How did you make sure that you were able to understand it in such a short span of time?
So for accounts, I had referred to some material of some institute. I had watched the videos and they had provided videos also. So those videos I had revised multiple number of times. And that was my strategy for accounts. Mm-hmm. And as far as costing is concerned, sir, I had watched your videos and I had given some mocks. And there were some revision videos. I don't remember the name of the sir who had published those videos. And he had done a lot of questions. I think those questions were really helpful and he had done it in a very good manner, I would say. So those videos were helpful. And costing, I think, sir, it may look difficult while we look at the syllabus, but it is not as difficult for engineers, I would say, because the concepts are not like accounts. For example, accounts is something completely new. We had never heard about accounts. But then for costing, something like, there are lots of topics that we can relate in a better manner, and it is relatively easier, I would say.
One thing that I can, I might be wrong, one thing that I'm probably concluding from this is that you like to visualize things when you're reading something.
Yes, yes.
So can you talk a little bit about that? Because I think visualization is something that a lot of students don't do subconsciously, and that hurts them because visualization is something that helps us remember things much, much better.
So I think, for example, in finance, there are a lot of topics related to stock markets. And then initially when I was reading through those topics, I could not understand anything. And right. I could understand a little bit, not much. And I was always having this doubt in the back of my head whether I'm understanding the right thing or I'm understanding the wrong thing. So I had watched some videos on YouTube also who explain things such as how to trade and how to invest. So those kinds of videos also were helpful to me. Like, and I had also made a demat account so that I could understand things better. So I think, although my purpose was not to invest and earn money, but then I thought that it would help me and it actually helped me. That is how I had tried to create things.
There is one more thing that I'm coming to, although it is a little out of what we are discussing right now. A lot of times we see students preparing book-wise or subject-wise rather than topic-wise. For example, when you're talking about finance and stock markets, for example. So it is one topic. Okay. Student ko lagta hai ki hum pehle pura finance cover kar lete hain, even if we are not able to understand anything. And we will stick to, let's say, one book only. Ki Bharti V Pathak hai, toh bas Bharti V Pathak se pura finance pad lenge. It doesn't matter if we are able to understand it or not, and then we'll move to any other source. That is going book wise. Okay. Topic wise is what you are referring to. Jaise ki humne stock market uthaya. And if I feel that Bharti V Pathak is probably not enough, or I'm not able to understand it to the level I want to, then I go to any other source. And let's say that is not enough, then I go to any other source, a third source, then I go to a fourth source. I might not have to do that for any other topic, right? So this is going topic wise, and the first one was going book wise. Am I right in saying that you were going topic wise subconsciously rather than going book wise?
Yes, sir, definitely you are right. Because I was going topic wise and I was trying, and somewhere in some of the topics I had made mistakes and I had just skimmed through those topics. But I would suggest for future aspirants that this should not be done. And I had regretted that later on because I had to devote more time later on. So I think, sir, you should go topic wise and understand each and every topic in a thorough manner. And right. It is very important that we have the syllabus in the back of our mind so right. that we can always relate. And it is also important that we try and refer to previous questions, because right. those are the most important questions that that tell us about the types of questions that will be thrown at us. So right. it is very important that we have the
right sources. You're right. Now, moving forward, economics, micro and macro, what was your strategy?
Economics, sir.
Yes.
Sir, economics, I had watched videos of yours. And also, I think, sir, there were videos of RBI also. So, all those videos I had watched, I had made notes. and I had revised those notes multiple number of times, and whatever topics which I could not understand, I had to go to some other sources.
Right, right. Perfect. That is perfect. Did you have any different strategy in management, or did you follow the same?
For management, was that I had just skimmed through management because I thought it is a relatively easier subject and I should save time on management. But I think the questions that are asked in management are very tricky, that get a lot of trickinesses involved in those top questions. So I would not suggest for future listeners that they should follow the same strategy. One should try and understand each and every topic and deal with it seriously, because ultimately it is one of the major topics of the syllabus. Mm-hmm. So I had watched videos and then I had referred to the videos. That is what I had done for management.
Perfect, perfect. I think, yeah, we all make mistakes when we prepare for whatever we are doing, whatever we are preparing for. Okay. So right now we are expecting the exam might be held before December for the year 2021. For all the students who are especially from non-commerce background, they always have this question, how much time is enough for the preparation? So can you elaborate a little bit on that? How much time did you spend in total, and how much time do you think as an engineer would be enough to prepare well?
So broadly, I think if I dedicate around 6 to 7 months and 2.5 to 3 hours on a daily basis, then that will suffice. And one has to be very smart in that, because we have to constantly refer to syllabus. I think it's very important, constantly referring to syllabus and research questions and giving marks in between. And we should not give a lot of marks, because a lot of marks would help. They do more harm than good, because we end up spending a lot of time in marks. And then that it is more important that we give marks, analyze what type of questions are asked in the exam, and then proceed. So that analysis part is important, so that we understand the types of questions. So marks, syllabus, these are questions, and constant revision is what I would suggest for future aspirants. And around 2.5 to 3 hours on a daily basis for around 6 to 7 months. Or
7 months is good enough. Okay. Do you want to talk about the interview experience? Because I think that must have been unique for a student of your background.
So I thought generally I have given other interviews also, like people look at my background and then ask about some HR questions, like how is Mizoram as a place, something like that. But my interview was, I think it was held at around 1 p.m. So that was around lunchtime, maybe because of that, but I don't know the reason. They were very fast in the interview, and it did not last for long. I think it lasted for around 10 minutes. And they asked me only technical questions, apart from one question, which was, why do you want to fit NCA? Or sorry, how would you fit NCA? So that was one question. Which was HR based. Other than that, all the questions were technical, and they were thrown at me back to back in very rapid fire. So some of the questions were like, would be, what is commodity derivatives market, and what is spoofing? Such kinds of questions were asked. Not many cross questions were asked on my answers.
Okay. So did you prepare something separately for the interview, or was your preparation of, I'm assuming that majority of the questions must have been from finance and from the stock markets. So did the preparation for mains and phase one, was that sufficient, or did you prepare anything separately, completely separately for the interview?
Yes, sir. I had prepared completely separately. I would say before phase two, I had prepared to current affairs. As in newspaper, I had prepared only magazines. Whereas after the results of phase two were out, I started referring to Lightning on a regular basis, because it is important that we form an opinion of our own. Although my interview was completely not on current affairs, rather not even a single question was on current affairs, but then there are, it is a possibility that all the questions can be based on current affairs. So that is what I would suggest, that current affairs should be given emphasis. And apart from that, website of SEBI is very important. We should refer to the website thoroughly, and everything we should look at. Also, SEBI annual report and Munch Policy Committee, such reports are very important, I would say. And syllabus, as far as syllabus is concerned, subjects like Companies Act, management, costing can be neglected. Not neglected, but they need not be given a lot of emphasis. And more emphasis should be given on finance and commerce. That is what I felt. And mostly when I was talking to others also, they also felt the same. The interviews were also on the same.
So the focus is more on current affairs and finance. These are the two ways.
Yes,
right?
And about our current biodata and about SEBI.
About SEBI. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Perfect. So to end with, any advice or anything you would want to tell all the aspirants who are preparing this year?
So, sir, I think initially when I started my preparation, I thought I'm competing with students of commerce backgrounds, then I might not be able to. That negative thought was there. But then when I analyzed and when I thought, no, I have to clear this exam. At that time, I was trying to look at positives. For example, that notification which I talked about. Because the notification says engineers are eligible, that means I'm eligible. And I'm, if I'm open, I should be able to clear. So the positive thought is very important. And we should keep all the phases in our mind. And not only prepare for phase one, before phase one. We should prepare in a holistic manner, I would say. That is important. A positive attitude is important. And I think the right sources are important. Limited number of sources. So. And motivation has to come from that is something which I would emphasize.
Right. Apna time or apni age kyun kharab karni hai in running after something that you feel that you cannot do, right? Very well, very well said. Beautiful. So that is all that we have from Vishwaneeth. I believe that a lot of aspirants are going to be helped out from this video, from this small session that we've had. For any questions that you might have, from Vishwaneeth or from me, you can put it in the comment section below. All the best, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.